at the United Nations to destroy a country. It's very easy. I know this is a signal for me to stop.
Our final speaker, to the surprise of many of you, is Ambassador Bashar Jafari, the permanent representative of the Syrian Arab Republic to the United Nations. Ambassador.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming on this Saturday, hot Saturday, humid Saturday. Thank you. So thank you so much for coming this very hot and humid Saturday to listen to us. I know that sometimes politics are boring, would bore the listeners. However, the issue is very important. It's not only about Syria, but it is about all of us. It's about USA, it's about Syria, Iraq, the Middle East, the whole Middle East, the whole world. And we will try to elaborate a little bit by adding to what my distinguished colleague, the Honorable Senator Richard Black, has just pointed out, and to what Mr. Ramsey Clark, also my distinguished friend, said before my arrival. Well, history has shown to us that lies are not and could not be eternal. We know for sure nowadays that history, many tragic episodes in history were based on lies, meaning they were baseless and without any foundation. I could share with you hundreds of examples about what I am saying, derived all of them from the UN itself, from the United Nations, where I represent my country. I think that Senator Black and Mr. Ramsey Clark have not left too much for me to say. However, we have indeed too many information to share with you. We could speak about what's going on in the world in general, but in Syria in particular, for hours, if not for days. And you would be surprised, because you have never heard anything of this information I'm going to share with you. It is a great honor for me to have the opportunity to address this August audience from this podium in St. Bartholomew's Church in Manhattan. I convey to you my sincere salutes and best wishes, and I thank Schiller Institute and thank you all for offering this great honor to me and to my colleagues. We meet today while we all are recalling the tragedy of September 11. It was one of the most sad and grievous days in the whole history of the United States. It also was a harsh and difficult lesson to learn for all nations and governments that terrorism recognizes no boundaries or identities and therefore should not be justified, protected or concealed. I'm saying this because Senator Black has somehow gave some hints about the Saudi links to the events of 9/11. And I will elaborate a little bit on this issue later on. 15 out of the 19 terrorists who did the 9/11 attacks were Saudis. They were not Syrians. They were not Iraqis. They were not Algerians. They were Saudis. These same Saudis formed by what is called, commonly speaking, the Wahhabism, which derives from the name of the founder of this school of thought, Muhammad Abdul Wahhab. Wahhabism derives from Abdul Wahhab, who appeared out of a sudden in the Hijaz, the old name of Saudi Arabia, which is a fake name, actually. Saudi Arabia is a fake name of the country, because Saudi means Al Saud, the family of Saud. So as if you are changing the name of your own country to become the United States of Obama. So they stole, this family stole the name of the country and transformed this country to fit to their radical agenda. That happened in the late 18th century. The funny part of the story is that this school of thought was facilitated, created, and endorsed by the British intelligence at that time. So the British intelligence facilitated the creation of this radical movement in Islam on purpose, of course. You know the British, how they act. Nothing is for free. Immediately in 1815, this crazy guy moved towards Damascus and Karbala in Iraq. In Karbala, he attacked the shrines of the Shia Muslims. And in Damascus, he tried to invade the city, but the Syrians stopped him and defeated him on the doors at the walls of Damascus. Then he retreated and came back to where he came from. I'm giving you this background to show to you that this crazy movement is not a newcomer. It has been there for centuries. Couple of times protected by the British, then by the Americans. It is not because they like them, but it is because their craziness fits to their agenda. Islam is not about Saudi Arabia. In Damascus, in the greatest mosque of Damascus, called the Umayyad Mosque, in the middle, in the heart of the mosque, which is the greatest, the biggest and greatest mosque in Syria, we have the shrine of Saint John the Baptist inside the mosque. The grave of Saint John the Baptist is in the middle of the mosque, where Muslims as well as Christians visit the grave and make their prayers. Senator Black told you about the Mufti of Syria, this wonderful man. Could you believe that his main advisor, I mean, his political advisor, is a Christian? The Mufti's political advisor is Christian. Only in Syria. Only in Syria. This is why we are extremely proud of our secularism.